course.
Have you ever steal money from strangers?
No.
I have one question. Have you ever fart in the classroom?
Yeah.
Yes.
No. When I was in junior high school.
Yeah. I see something different in your facial expressions when I ask you the first and second questions.
Yeah.
You know, this facial expressions is happen unconsciously as you try to prove that you are not lying and you are not covering the truth. And this lying is one of the trouble matters in humans' natures. And it's often turns people into creepy. But it can be useful too when you're eating the last piece of your sister's chocolates and you're trying to cover it up. Well, it can be used in a situation when you are trying to find a guy or a person to be more creative. You want to find a good person who match with your own qualifications, but you don't really know who are the candidates. Or it can be useful, the lying. It can happen when you want to make sure that your boyfriend is not hang out with other people outside. But as you can't read other people's mind, it may be hard for you to detect if they are lying or not. So today, I, Devita Ramadanti, will tell you some steps, basic steps, to identify a person who is lying to you. The first step that you may use is detecting lies in the face. There are three indicators in detecting lies in the face. The first is micro-expressions. Did you know what is micro-expressions?
Yeah.
Micro-expression is some facial expression that appears in a glimpse and it shows your true emotions. Like, for example, if you're happy, then you may have some wrinkles here. And then your cheeks will push up. But if a happy person who says, "I'm happy," and he or she not showing this in glitters, she or he may be lying to you. And then the next indicator is the nose touching or mouth covering. If something happened unconsciously as the person is trying to block the truth coming up from his or her mouth. Okay, the third indicator in the face that you may use in detecting people lying is the eye contact. Usually people say that a person with good eye contact tells the truth, but it's not, you know, because when a person sees to another side or looking for another non-moving object, he or she is actually remembering something, like I remembered yesterday, like that. But nowadays, a liar is really brilliant. He or she already prepared it before. So he or she maybe have prepared to have a good eye contact to you, so you may be believed in what he or she has said. And then the second step is detecting lies in the verbal responses. The first thing to be paying attention is the person's voice. If he or she suddenly stammering, like or he or she suddenly talk faster or slower than before, it can be a sign that they are lying. Or if suddenly he or she have a high pitch, like no, suddenly you're just saying that, it can be a sign. And then the next thing is exaggerating. For example, my mom used to live in France. Isn't it nice to live there? You know, the Eiffel Tower is so tall, the air is so nice, and then the green things outside, like that. It's so exaggerating, you know. And it can be a sign that they are lying, because it's her mother who lived in France, not him or her. The third is the usage of words. If he or she suddenly repeat your questions, for example, I ask, "Have you had lunch this afternoon?" And then a person responds, "No, I haven't eaten lunch this afternoon." It's repeat the direct questions like this. It can be assigned too, because he only copy what you have said. Especially when you want to pay them for lunch. Now, the other usage of word that we can use as a sign is the contractions. Usually people who tell the truth say, "I didn't do it." It's like a contraction.
Stress.
Yeah, a stress. But the liars may say, "I did not do it," because he or she wants to emphasize that you're not lying. Find a sign inside it. And then the other thing is, he or she saying, "To be honest." To be honest, or "I haven't lied before." Like saying something that explaining that he or she not lying to you. It may be a sign that he or she actually lying. And then the third steps to identify is identifying in the body language. The first is sweating. If a person suddenly sweat a lot, it can be a sign too that they are lying, because of the adrenaline hormones that run through the blood vessels inside the body. But it not directly show that he or she are lying, because it can be a sign to that he or she are nervous, or the temperature is hot, like that. And then the other thing is leaning. If suddenly people lean backward when telling some things, he or she may be telling you lie. And then grooming. Make it this.
Yeah.
Or suddenly adjusting the tie or the color, something like that. Now, he or she may be telling you lie. And then the other thing is knots or shape. When you ask, did you do this? But he or she say, "No, I didn't do it. Did not do it, you know," but he keeps nodding. So it shows that it's actually he is actually lying. It can be fun too. Well, that's all are the steps to identify a person who are lying. But you cannot fully judge a person who are showing one of or more or of the sign that I have mentioned before, then he or she are lying, because it can be another reasons for that, such as the nervous or another things. But still, it's important for you to know this information, because you never know who is the person that you will meet in the next special occasion.